Hey, down here. Okay, we're back up under the hood of the old 1976 Blazer. Let me play. I forgot to plug in my power cord, so the battery won't be able to work. Okay, yeah, I'll take the breather off and just to make sure it's not in the way. I can put that air cleaner over there and let it sit on the up under the hood and on the power brake booster. But yeah, I'm gonna take this fuel filter off and clean it, and I think I'll go ahead and take it off at this end, and that way I can inspect this older. This is all new now. I don't want to, and also don't want to accidentally move that up or down and break loose my sealer I put on there in my forming gasket. Usually I do take this one or this one. That was hard to get on there. It's a brand new hose. Well, this one's hard to get to, though. This one is down there is in a spot because it has the old original metal fuel line coming up, and then it got, well, the connector got to where it wouldn't spin or something, or it got bent. I don't remember anyway. I cut it off down there. It might have rubbed a hole in it, got a leak, I can't remember. But I cut it off down there just to where you could get to it. And years ago, and ever so often I have to replace that hose. When they started mandatory making you put ethanol, alcohol in the gas, it causes so much trouble for engines and eats up the hoses. I've got some hose now that I bought from a boat part company. It was actually cheaper as I could find anywhere of that type of hose, but it's supposed to stand up to this ethanol better. And if I let my hose clamp go way down there, it's really hard to get back up. So let me grab that if I can. I'm grabbing it. Looks like it's going to stay there. I left it thinking it would stay before, and it didn't stay. And I spent 10 minutes getting it back up over everything. Okay, try to get as little. I'm going to tag it off for now. It's not. If I have to unscrew it all the way to put it back on, it's not the end of the world. Yeah. I can't smell the gas that well. I didn't want to put them rubbery gloves on that. Such a pain to sweat your hands. But I didn't want gas all over my, these are some really old gloves, so not that worried about getting this gas on. So, I'll unscrew that thing. Let me put it down where it can drain. Then I'll unscrew it. And I don't smell that varnishy smell, so maybe the only, hopefully, yeah, I think that's okay. Hopefully the varnishy smelling fuel was just in the carburetor, but it hasn't. I thought it might be the whole tank because normally, if it's been started yesterday and you start it today, then it'll just crank over the first or second hit. And it hasn't been doing that. And also, I didn't take the back bolt off. So, you know, took a chance on that. But I really haven't opened up the back barrels either, now that I think about it. I didn't get any half-inch wrenches or anything. I just grabbed my basic stuff. Wasn't really thinking. I tightened that up pretty good. I'm going to have to go get me some wrenches. I tightened it up pretty good to make sure it doesn't leak. Okay, let me go get, I think they're half inch. Anyway, I'll go get a couple of wrenches. Thank you. I just grabbed my tray of end wrenches. I can't remember for sure, and I don't want to go back and forth. A painter's ladder makes a pretty good mechanic ladder too. Got that little tray on it, big old tray on it. Yeah, they're 9/16. I used to just know just what size just by looking at them. They are half inch. It was the rubber hose. Thought that was on. Anyway, so, you know, the really common ones like that, I used to really be good at identifying them just by looking at them. Here we go. Let's see if one of these will get in there with that rubber hose. And this is a ratcheting one here. Just gotta know which way to put it on. Oh, it did go that way. Pretty cool, huh? Pretty hard to do this with big old gloves on, but I don't care. I just don't really want to. Didn't want to wear those little blue gloves. And I don't want my fingers getting all gassed up and cracking some more. Let's see. May have to take these gloves off though, because you end up starting dropping stuff in the dirt. But there's that seal. That's okay. Could be a little bit of grime in it. I'll take the air blower after a doll here as soon as I get this off in here. Now, I don't know if you've never seen one of these. See, it's a glass tube. And that way you can see through it. And then you turn this little part right here to get the actual filter off. There we go. Then you have to unscrew it all the way off of there. And then that shaft. The shaft has a hole, it's hollow in the middle and has another hole there to let the gas go on through to the carburetor. You know, it really doesn't look. Got more new gas coming out. Can't see it all that good myself up under the hood here. I'll get it out in the light. But I mean, it's old and yellow, but it doesn't look like it's got. I don't see any dirt on the, you know, the inside. Maybe just the tiniest little bit. I'll get some spray cleaner after it. And I'll blow out that thing. So, I've got to get down again. Oh. It's hard to move that camera, so I'm not going to move it. Thank you. I just went ahead and blew those off. I think it might be dirty. It scratched up so bad. I don't know if cleaning it would help. That's pretty good shape. The other one down there on it came loose out of its slot. Luckily it didn't fall out. There goes the helicopter. It's actually the care flight. We have a hospital within like one, it's like a, not just a couple, football field and a half away from here probably. It's, I guess you could say it's like three blocks if you're walking. But yeah, it's all yellow, but it's not torn anywhere. That's what I want to get the magnifying glass for, to look in there. It's some kind of mesh cloth like stuff. It's plastic, I'm sure. I guess. Yeah, if they ever tear, you better get another one. Because it's just going to let dirt through. And specks of crap that would clog up your carburetor. And you won't like that. Okay, let's see. Light quit working. That was awful handy. I had a magnifying glass and a light all in one. Quit working the other day. Okay, let's see. I didn't use my light as my plug-in this time. I just told them that. Because it was easier to use to drag around than the hose. Well, I mean the hose. The regular extension cord. It was easier. I didn't really think I'd necessarily need the light, but it would be a little bit handy. There. Just get it tight enough to hold it, but don't break it. Where's the glass? There it is. Now that, I think I will... I didn't blow it out, I forgot. I think I'll clean it with my denatured alcohol that I had out a while ago. That way I can see through it good and tell whether or not there's specks in there. Get up here by the camera. I went ahead and got my little gloves because no way to do this without saturating your hands. See. The little lid works good. You have to have a screwdriver to open it up. Put it through there so that I can break some off so I can do that. rubbing around and around. If I wasn't so close, it would be better. Clean, it doesn't have that yellow tint to it anymore, so I should be able to tell. Let me get my magnifying glass and look at this other seal. Yeah, it looks okay. Okay, now yeah, with these gloves I can put it back on there without having such a risk of dropping it back in the dirt and ruining all my good work. Oh. Okay. Now this is aluminum and glass, so you don't want to do it so much that you break anything. But you don't want to leave it too loose because then it'll leak on you. That should be good. So, get the glass after it again, see if I can see this. Yeah, I don't see a single crack in there. I think I've replaced it in the last couple of years. I might have put some of that good stuff on it too. Yeah, I was already stretched out, so it wasn't too hard to put back on. Sure, it's all as far as I can get it. They don't make them long enough for you to... They're barely wide as the hose clamp right there. And you really want about a quarter of an inch off the end of your hose to keep it from... It'll try to push the hose off if you get right on the end of the hose. But you can't hardly do that. You can get maybe an eighth of an inch. Oh, that darn. I'm gonna have to get another clamp. That one's not any good anymore. Worn out. We'll get one. Those brand new ones I got are actually weaker than the older ones so far. But I gotta go get a new one from, I guess, my toolbox in the truck. Take that one off and leave it off. Last time on this other one, I went ahead and put a new one here and an old one up there to kind of give it two chances to hang on. But that one is a really long inlet. Yeah, I think since I already know sometimes these older ones, at least, if the screw don't break off there like that other new one did, then you can just use them in a different spot because they'll strip on the perforated area of the clamp, and the screw mechanism and all will still be good. I don't know if I can show it. Yeah, it looks pretty worn. I think you'll be able to see it, but that whole area right in there is bent. When it starts getting like that bent in a concave looking, then that's when they'll start not hanging on anymore, even though this part is okay. The other one broke off. Okay, so I've got our used one. That's probably from the older age enough that it's still good, it's still strong. Let's look at it first, see if it looks stripped. Glass. Well, it's got some wear and tear on it right there. Probably, well, these are shorter ones, these newer, that one and the newer one. It's got some wear and tear right there where it's probably going to need to be grabbing. I don't know if it's going to show up, but maybe since there's a lot of light there. I'll try this new one, but I'm maybe since that's not an old, really old hard hose, it'll be able to do it before it strips. I don't know where I bought these. I got to figure out. I know I ordered them because they're in a little sack, and I remember ordering some. And if they're all weak pieces of crap, so I need to make sure I never order from that outfit again. It's neat. It's nice to just order stuff, but boy, when you get something crappy. You know, I mean, it's too much trouble. Well, especially when you get something like this and you don't use it for 2 or 3 years. Let's see. I make sure it's still up on there pretty good. Yeah, I learned a long back in the 70s or to leave as much as you can, a quarter inch, eighth inch on the end of the hose, because it depends on what you're putting it on, but a lot of the hose it looks fine, but then if you have it out to the edge of the hose, that's what I'm talking about. You see, I don't know if you can see a bunch of rubber sticking out there. I left as much, I shoved it up over the nut part of it. That's why it was in the way. And this one, it's older part of the shove, so I got it right up to it, but I do have about an eighth inch. Just fits, but if these were longer, like they really should be, like things used to be, they get rid of every millimeter or every, you know, they take away every millimeter or every thousandths of an inch they can to save money on materials now, instead of thinking about functionality and quality with everything. And that one just pops loose. It's really not doing anything. That's one of those new ones I was talking about. It's so broken. It's not worth being there. Take it off. We'll see if it may be better off. Oh, and the screw's coming out of it. This is what the other one, this is what his little sister brother did. Screw just screwed right out of it. That used to. I've got hose clamps that are years and years, 10, 15, 20 years old that haven't done that yet. Only thing wrong with them is they've just worn and bent a little bit right there where the screw grabs on them. And you can bang on them. Used to, I would bang on them and flatten them out with a hammer. But that's brand new and it's already like that. Already all out of shape. Put that on 3 days, 4 days ago, brand new. You can bang on them, straighten them out and get them working again, but not, you know, you never know when they might let go. What I have on there, I never have really put two on there. I was worried about it not being tight enough. It seems okay now. But that's that long, it sticks out, there's plenty of room for two. I think I use this old one alongside of that other old one. I just feel a little bit, just don't want nothing leaking. this hose is probably too big. Let's try that one that... Yeah, let's try that other one that was... It'll grab in a different place. Oh, no, it won't. I think this one's not big enough for this hose. This is a little bit bigger hose. Oh, and sometimes when they bend, squeeze down real tight on a smaller hose, it will bend right there, see, and that will dig into your hose and cut it, so you don't want to leave it like that either. So whichever one I use, take your pliers and squeeze it back straighter, a little, not too straight, but get some of that out of there. Can't do it up in front of the camera too well. Other one too, because it's actually like that too, the one that's really a lot longer. Try this longer one. I don't know. Those are indispensable when you need a longer one. Because if I needed a longer one, if I was on a big, lot bigger hose, then it would grab in a different place. And it might still work okay. Use this one that's just barely long enough. And I won't put it real tight. I'll just snug it up. That right there. Yeah. And yeah, those brand new ones. I'm scared to keep using them. I'm afraid they're gonna just bust loose on me when I least expect it. Only good thing is, as the hoses stay there long enough, they kind of stick. Kind of stick to the metal. And they don't ever, you know how they are. They never want to come off if you've ever pulled them off. And so I've seen the. Once in a great while, I've seen a hose clamp be broken and not even leaking fuel. Of course, if it gets hot enough or something, it's all just probably everything expands. Okay. I'm getting pretty hungry for lunch now, so I'm going to grease the U-joints, but I'll do that after lunch. Maybe the shade will be around more to where I won't be right in the... Right in the... Now, I was fixing to open up the power steering, but I checked that the other day. Okay, so we're good. Let's do start it before we put the air cleaner on it, see how everything is. And, okay, here we go, start her up. Thank you. Okay, that's looking good. Hit my head. That's much better. Right, I gotta go back up there to put that air cleaner back on. Yeah, it's right there where I'll bang into it. Okay. Stays up pretty good though. I'm good. That coat hanger, it's one of those, I don't wonder what the holder is, but anyway, the coat hanger is what's hanging it. But I've got it stuck up in there pretty tight. So. Yeah, I couldn't see nothing down in the carburetor. I wanted to see what the fuel jets looked like, you know, the jet of fuel looked like, but I can't see it. So, I was thinking about revving it up and seeing if I could see the accelerator pump kicking in. I was wondering about that, but I'll drive it first. If I drive it and warm it up and it still acts like it's bogging out when you give it the gas, then I could have accelerator pump not working right. I did spray it with some fuel injector, map sensor cleaner, but that shouldn't have eaten it up, I don't think. And I also didn't just saturate it or let it sit there with it on it for a long time. But, and of course it could have just been old too. It looked okay. It seemed to feel like it was working, and it didn't inspect it real close. I really should have inspected it, see if it had any visible signs of age. I didn't kind of looked at it, but I didn't get it in a good light and was seriously inspecting. I should have, now that I think about it. If I did, I don't remember anyway. Okay, so yeah, after lunch I'll grease your joints and then I'm going to take him for a little test drive around the block and see how he does. Good place for the camera, but it doesn't sit still enough, does it? All right, it's done. I'll be back later.